Good morning, God. This is your day. I am your child. Show me your way. We give thanks to you, Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have protected us through the night from all danger and harm. And we ask you to preserve and keep us this day also from sin and every evil, that in all our thoughts, words, and deeds we may love and serve you. Into your hands we commend our bodies and our souls and all that is ours. Let thy holy angel have charge over us. Let the wicked one have no power over us. Amen.
Hello, my name is Travis Grulke. I am the superintendent of our Michigan District Lutheran Schools, and I am blessed to work with all of our Lutheran schools, about 145 or so, throughout the whole state. Hope to take a few minutes and just share a few things that I've been thinking about in terms of all the stuff that we're dealing with during this kind of crazy time. So I want to talk about some what-ifs. I know right now we're thinking, man, what if this happens? What does this mean for school? And if you're like me, I got all these what-ifs that are kind of swimming through my head. So it reminded me of my favorite poet, Shel Silverstein, who I think is a brilliant author. And if you don't have any of his books, you can see his stuff online as well and check out some of his great things. But one of his poems is called What If? And here's how it goes. Last night, while I was laying thinking here, some what-ifs crawled inside my ear and pranced and partied all night long and sang their same old what-if song. What if I'm dumb in school? What if they've closed the swimming pool? What if I get beat up? What if there's poison in my cup? What if I start to cry? What if I get sick and die? What if I flunk the test? What if green hair grows on my chest? What if nobody likes me? What if a lightning bolt strikes me? What if I grow taller? What if my head starts getting smaller? What if the fish won't bite? What if the wind tears up my kite? What if they start a war? What if my parents get divorced? What if the bus is late? What if my teeth don't grow in straight? What if I tear my pants? What if I never learn to dance? Everything seems swell, and then the nighttime what-ifs strike again. I love this little poem. It's got some serious things in it, obviously. It's also got some funny stuff, but it also reminds us that, man, there's a lot of stuff that sometimes jumps in our head with all these questions and these worries and all these things going on. And if you're like me, man, right now I got a lot of them. I think your teachers do too. I think your parents do too. So whenever I'm kind of wrestling with all this anxiety and fear and sometimes worry and all these questions that I don't have answers to, the best place to go, as we know, is the Bible. And it helps us just learn a few things. And I want to show you one of my favorite little parts of Scripture, and that's from Philippians 4. And I turn to this verse and these parts of Scripture when I have a lot of those what-ifs that are jumping through my head. I just want to talk to you about it really quickly. And it starts out with this beginning. Paul shares with us something that we should be doing constantly. It says, rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. That's a famous part of Scripture. And notice he uses that word always. He doesn't just mean rejoice when things are great, rejoice when it's 70 and sunny, rejoice when everything's are back to normal. He says, rejoice in the Lord always. Even during this crazy time that we don't know kind of for sure what's going to happen, sometimes day to day or week to week, we know that we're to look to our good Lord and thank him, praise him for those rejoicing times. But also, Paul goes on to say, let your gentleness be evident to all, for the Lord is near. Whew, we're kind of stuck together with people right now. We can't really get out in different ways. And sometimes, again, if you're like me, my gentleness is not always evident to all. Sometimes my daughters may test my patience all the way to the end and my gentleness isn't there. Maybe sometimes your siblings and things kind of get on your nerves and your gentleness is not really evident there. But if we're rejoicing, as Paul tells us to do, and thanking God for our many blessings, it allows us to do an even better job of kind of sharing that gentleness because we know that God is near us no matter what. He keeps going on and says, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. Oh, I got to do that more often. I know when I get anxious, and that word anxious means we start to worry about things that are going on in the future that we don't quite know what's going to happen. And we need to do as best we can to take all of our requests, all of our worries, all of our anxieties, and do things with thanksgiving by saying, thank you, God, despite all the stuff I don't know. I know that your love and your grace and your forgiveness are there for me. So I'm going to put all that stuff at your feet, and I'm going to put those requests to you through prayer and through my conversations with you on a daily basis. But he ends with my favorite part. And he adds this little piece here that says, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding. And I know that's kind of a phrase that's a little bit big. We don't kind of understand that sometimes for you little ones. Even the big ones sometimes kind of get confused about this a little bit. But God's peace and the comfort that he gives you and me is something that our puny little human minds can't really understand. It's the peace that he gives us. It's the reassurance that he gives us because we rejoice in him. We give him all of our cares and our concerns. We thank him for all of our many blessings. And that peace comes to us that transcends all understanding. And he guards our hearts and minds because of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And Paul ends this little part in scripture here with this little thing. It says, finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. I got this on a little mouse pad sitting next to my computer, and it reminds me that when I'm thinking about things that are true and noble and trustworthy and praiseworthy and excellent, when I have those things going on in my mind, there's less room for those what-ifs and those questions to creep in, and those doubts and those worries and those anxieties. Because God knows when I fill my head with all those great gifts and all those things that he gives me, that other stuff can't seem to get in there so well. So my challenge to you is to do all you can to make sure you're thinking about all those noble things, those upright things, those trustworthy things, those excellent things, so some of those what-ifs and things don't creep in so much. And when they do, because I know they're going to, and I know for you teachers and for you parents and all those that are struggling with the what-ifs right now, I hope you're looking at your Heavenly Father, and I hope you're looking to him as best we can, thanking him and giving him praise and adoration for all the things he has given us, knowing that no matter what, he's got control of this. No matter what, we got a God who's bigger than our what-ifs and bigger than our anxieties, because he's got it figured out. Now he's hopefully going to clue us in pretty quickly on some of these answers to all the questions that we have. But again, we thank and praise him for all the many things he gives us. So why don't you fold your hands and bow your heads, and I'll have a little word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you for all the gifts that you give us. We thank you that we get to rejoice in you always for all the blessings and for all the things that you're able to do for us on a daily basis. We ask that you be with us right now as we got a lot of what-ifs that are creeping into our heads, a lot of questions, a lot of anxiety, a lot of worries about what the future may or may not hold for us. We know that you're a big God, you're a mighty God, you're a God that has all this under control. Please continue to be with us. Help us to share our blessings with those around us, those who need it. Help us to keep those worries away and those what-ifs away as we fill our heads with all those right and just and trustworthy and praiseworthy things that we know that you have put into our life. We again thank and praise you for our many blessings. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. We love you, Jesus, and all God's people boldly say, amen. My prayer for all of you as well in the coming weeks and coming months is that you keep focusing on him. I know we got a lot of challenges in front of us. To all of you are my prayers. Thank you, teachers. Thank you, parents. Thank you, students, for how quickly you have adapted and done a fantastic job. And I wish you God's continued peace that transcends all human understanding as we continue to go through this together and continue to thank and praise him for all the things that he gives us. Blessings.
Okay. Oh, you gotta press N. We're gonna say it again. Here we go. Hands are folded. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come,
Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
On your name.